Hi guys, it's Shelley here. Welcome to my channel and thank you for joining me today. On the video today, I'll be doing a colour along from Emelie, Lidehall, Oberg's Fairytales. And the page I'll be doing is the bunny page with the ice skates around its neck. This was one of the popular requests that I got from the video I had shared for my winter colouring options. And I know that was 3 months ago, but I did say that my colour alongs and the pages I'll be colouring will be covering 3 months. So December, January and February. And so this is my last winter colour along finally. Hopefully the videos that follow, the colour alongs that follow, will be spring-based pages, which I've already shared in a video a couple of weeks ago, I think, for my options for spring. So from March, April and May. And I've got, I've tallied everything up and I've sort of got a rough list of pages that I may try and do as colour alongs. So yeah, let's get to this last winter page. I haven't coloured in this book, Fairytales, for a long, long time, and I actually struggle colouring in this book. The paper is amazing. Emelie Lidehall Oberg's artwork is brilliant, but I do find her art style a little bit difficult for me, or a little bit challenging for me to colour, because she does have quite a bit of patterns or quite a bit of lines all over the page, and so basically it's hard for me to see how to color the page. But fortunately, this page, I have been looking at it for quite a long time and I just haven't got around to it. There's not that much patterns on this particular page, so yeah, I was really happy to finally color in this book again. For the page, I'll be using Neocolor 2s for the background, and then I'll be using a combination of my Faber Castell Albrecht Dürer pencils and Tombow dual brush pens for the rest of the page. And then right at the end, to finish everything off, I will be using some Tooli-art paint pens, some glitter gel pens, metallic gel pens, and I'll right at the end sprinkled the page with Winsor & Newton white ink to give a snowy effect. As I do most of the time, I started with the background first and I decided to go for the Neocolor 2s. And I wanted to bring across a wintry look, and so I decided to go for purples. I didn't want to go for blues. I've been using a lot of blue recently in a lot of my pages, so I decided to stick to purple and pinks for the background. And yeah, so I used the Neocolor 2s, and then I wanted to try a bouquet sort of a background, and I thought that I would be able to do that with just picking up color off the Neocolor 2s, because they're water-based, by using a paintbrush and some water and a stencil with circles on it to try and pick up the a little bit of the color off the page. However, even though this paper is really, really good, really thick, the paper did actually pill. And so I had to change plan and I decided to try my electric eraser with the stencils and see whether that would erase a little bit of the color despite having activated the Neocolor 2s. Fortunately, this did work, and I went ahead and did a little bit of erasing using the stencils to create a sort of bokeh background. Once the background was done, the easiest thing for me to do next was to do the leaves and the berries, because I knew I was going to keep them conventional in that I was going to go for green leaves, and the berries I was going to make sort of like a pinkish, just to bring in the pinks from the background. And so yeah, I went ahead and did the leaves. I did activate the pencils with water before going over the base with pencils dry. And for the berries, I just went ahead and did the berries with the pencils dry, if I remember correctly. I didn't activate with the water. I show a little portion of me colouring the leaves and the berries, like I do quite often. Because it was going to become quite repetitive, I was going to do exactly the same for all the leaves and berries. So I show a little example of how I do them, and then I go off camera and just finish them off. Following doing the leaves and berries that surround the bunny, I thought I'd go ahead and do the bunny next, because I wasn't sure what colour I wanted to use for the coat, the scarf and the hat. So I decided I'll do the bunny first, and I started off with his eyes, because if you look at the eyes uncoloured, for some reason there are tons of circles around within the eye. So there's like at least what, 4 or 5 circles. And so when I looked at the eyes, I was like, I have no idea how to do the eyes. So I thought it best to tackle the eyes first. And I think I'm happy with how it turned out. I didn't know what to do with the outermost circle. So I just left it as it was and sort of tried to color in a little bit of fur at the end, surrounding the little border circle. But yeah, I think the eyes turned out okay in the end. I just basically colored over all the circles and covered them up, and yeah, I think it turned out perfect for me. Then I went ahead and finished the rest of the bunny. So I did the ears, and then I did worked on the fur, and I chose to go for grayish brown fur, and I show how to do that. And right at the end of the video, when I'm doing my embellishments with the paint pens and glitter gel pens, I use a Tooli-art paint pen to just add in a little bit more fur effect at the end. So you'll see that on the video as well. I think that just helps fluff up the fur a little bit, make it a little bit messier. So yeah, I tend to like putting in a little bit of paint pen to give more of a fur effect. Following this, I decided to go ahead and complete the clothing on the bunny. So the hat, the coat, and then the scarf. And I decided to sort of limit the colors. So I went for a greenish hat and coat, just a different green to the leaves. So I used deep cobalt green, and I think, did I use cobalt green? You'll see on screen. And I used a Tombow dual brush pen, a colored one, to blend out the pencils, rather than using water or a blender pen or just using pencils to blend it out. I thought it would just speed up the process, and it also just adds a little different touch of color that I don't have in my pencil set. So it does help. I really like actually using colored water-based markers to blend out my Albrecht Dürer pencils. It works really well. So once I'd done that, then I went over with the pencils dry just to deepen up the color, make it more bold like I like. And yeah, then I went ahead and did the scarf. I decided to keep the scarf simple pinks, again bringing in the color from the background and tying in everything in. And for the patterns, I colored over, if I'm not mistaken, I colored over some of the patterns, and I later used glitter gel pen to fill in some of the patterns with a pink glitter gel pen. And I think there was some vertical lines on the scarf, or lines on the scarf. I kept those uncolored, and I went over at the end with a gold metallic gel pen just to break up the pink on the scarf. I think the pinks worked really well with the cobalt greens, and yeah, so I was happy with how it all turned out. At the end, again, when I do the embellishments, I use a Tooli-art paint pen just to add a little bit of, not tassels, but you know, a little bit of lines at the end of the scarf. What is it called? I don't think I know the name for it, but you know, the little frilly bit at the end of the scarf. I just use a paint pen to add in that effect on the scarf. And yeah, then that to do the snowflakes, I decided that I was going to use my Spectrum Noir Sparkle Clear Glitter. And I'm using Albrecht Dürer's, which are water-based pencils. So I just used a couple of colours on the snowflakes, very roughly. And then I used the Spectrum Noir glitter to blend them out and just give a bit of sparkle to the snowflakes, which I later again then outlined with a white paint pen. And right at the end, off camera, as I would normally do, to give a snowy effect, I just did a sprinkling of Winsor & Newton white ink. Generally, I'm really happy with how the page turned out, actually, especially because at the beginning when I was trying to do the background and I messed up the page a little bit because the page pilled, or more than pilled, it could have torn when I was trying to do the circles with the method I was going to use. I decided to try it because it was really thick paper. I knew it was good paper, but I think for that sort of technique to create those circles using a paintbrush and water, you need to have good quality watercolor paper, I think. But I'm glad it worked with the eraser and I could carry it out. And yeah, it's a fairly simple page, actually, to be honest. I don't know why it's taken me so long to get around to doing the page. But I think wherever there's a very dominant presence of fur, I do tend to get intimidated a little bit. And I always put off pictures. So it did really help that you guys, there was a high vote for this particular page. So I finally got around to doing another page in this book after so long. So it was really nice. And I really enjoy working on this paper. The process is really enjoyable. And I like the end result. The pencils work really well. The Tombows work really well on the paper. And everything turns out so nice and vibrant. So yeah, I'm happy with how it turned out. I hope you guys enjoyed watching the colour along. And for those of you who have not coloured in this book for a long time, like myself, I hope you follow along. And if you do, please share your work with me. Like I always say, it does make me happy to see your completed pages, your versions of the pages. And yeah, so hopefully I will see some of them pop up. So I guess I'll leave you guys to the rest of the video. There's not much else to discuss about this page because it was so simple. So I'll leave you guys to it, and hopefully I will be back with you guys soon with another video with regards to another color along. Hopefully I'll be back with some spring pages now. I'm ready for the bright colors, the lots of flowers, landscapes. So yeah, hopefully I get time to do lots of spring pages. So until the next video, take care, thank you for watching, and bye bye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.